here to the blasting room with Bill and Jason. It's just, it's coming home. It's family for us, and they're a part of the band, you know what I mean, in a lot of ways. And so we hold their opinion in high regard. They feel free to interject, and they are helping create these songs just as much as the four of us are. And so it's a real collaborative process in that sense.
You know, we have a relationship where we can be blunt with each other, saying like, no, that sucks, like, why are you playing that? Or like, you know, which is good because it kind of cuts out all the, you know, the, you know, just the wasted time.
And I'm just saying, it we're spoiling that riff by overuse. And so it's like, somebody pick a spot, some spots to get rid of it and write something better, you know? That's, to be blunt. But that sounded good to me. That sounded really good.
I want to hear your one where he omits the kick, though.
What you just did sounded really good to me. It isn't what I hummed, but it sounded fucking awesome. Jason wants to hear the one that I hummed still, though.
It's nice when you have a producer who understands what you're going for. You know, it makes the communication easier. And as far as guitar tones, drum tones, I mean, that's like a science, and it's hard to sometimes convey how you want a guitar to sound or how you want drums to sound. And them being from punk rock bands, they just sort of understood immediately what we were going for, and it's been a great relationship.
As a sort of a kickoff or a send-off for us as we're wrapping our record up here, Zach decided that he was gonna find the Lemons, find this band, reunite them with their original drummer, fly them to Fort Collins, and have them play a bar here in town, unbeknownst to Bill. And he told us this idea, and we thought it was preposterous and impossible.
It is by far his favorite band of all time, and he thinks about them and listens to them constantly.
Do a mastering of the Lemons cassette. This is important.
Do it.
How do you master a cassette?
I mean, just to get it. They've been in my garage for like 12 years. Like, I'm a fucking idiot, you know? They're probably broken. They're probably not gonna play.
I just thought, what better gift than to possibly get his favorite band of all time back together to play one show for him. And Bill has no idea. He thinks Tim and I are playing an acoustic show down the street. So we're just gonna go down there and walk in, and his favorite band of all time is going to just start playing right when we walk in. And I mean, he is going to shit. Anyway, it's gonna be like better than 1,000 Christmases. Yeah.